DrinkABrick, we have a dream that this plastic bottle will someday look like this. Why? Because this small tweak in design can make a huge impact on the world we live in. Plastic bottles today come in all shapes and sizes, and there are a lot of them, a whole lot. They're wasteful, and worst of all, they take up to 1,000 years to decompose. It's expensive to get rid of them. Most of them end up contaminating our oceans and land, harming our planet. The DrinkABrick bottle is different. It's a bottle, and it's also a brick. Pretty cool, right? Its unique design allows it to be placed inside cement walls as internal bricks, kind of like these air bubbles, making the material lighter and cheaper, more sound absorbing, and providing thermal insulation. To take this project to the next step, we need to run standard certification tests for the DrinkABrick bottle. With the certified building material on our hands, these new bottles can be adopted by bottling companies and reused by the construction industry, significantly cutting costs of standard buildings. We would be reducing PET plastic pollution and lowering the world housing deficit at the same time. By donating to the DrinkABrick project, you will be investing in a better world, a cleaner world. And the best part is, next time you see your favorite soft drink on the shelf of your local supermarket, you can rest assured it will end up here instead of here. Build with us. DrinkABrick.
Air pollution is a really big problem, especially in big cities. Heavy traffic, pollen, ozone, and fire smoke. It all inflicts your daily air quality and in the end your health. At University of Southern California, graduate student Frederick Kraft came up with a solution when he was exercising outdoors around campus.
During my workout, I realized I couldn't breathe because the pollution level was way too high. At the time, I wished there was a tool that could show me when the best time to do a physical activity would be. So I decided to create the smartphone app Inhale. Inhale shows you the recommended start and stop time for your activity depending on the duration.
I've tried the Inhale app for a couple days now, and it's really convenient for me to plan my outdoor activities according to the time of day when I inhale the least amount of pollution. Since I'm allergic to pollen, it's important for me to avoid exercise outdoors when the amounts are too high. Inhale is really user-friendly, and you can plan up to 4 days ahead. Type in your zip code and the duration of the activity, and you're good to go.
Inhale is made even more powerful by placing an air quality sensor on the back of the new Motorola modular phone. By having the sensor on the back of the phone, users are able to collect data on the air they breathe in real time, no matter where they are. Our sleek design does all the work for you by only measuring the air quality when your phone is out of your pocket. You are the signal to the world that this is important. Inhale.
Thank you. number of disasters increases year on year, so does the need to supply aid to survivors. Getting the right food in the right place at the right time is difficult, particularly if the area of interest is vast and devastated, or if communications have broken down. Unmanned air vehicles are used in both natural and man-made disaster areas, but not for the precision delivery of humanitarian aid. With the arrival of Pouncer, that's all about to change. Pouncer offers governments and non-government organisations the ability to deliver regional, religious and culturally approved humanitarian food aid to those in need rapidly and with the maximum nutritional yield. The relatively low price point and value for money Pouncer offers keeps food miles to a sensible level too, making the system a perfect solution.
Pouncer is the first lightweight and flexible air vehicle available made from food. Available in three sizes, each Pouncer has been specifically designed to supply enough food, water, medical supplies or any other aid equipment for up to 100 survivors for one day. Working with Fraser Nash Consultancy, we have ensured that every element of the air vehicle has been designed for the survivor. The Mark 1 air vehicle will utilise an airframe built with lightweight, pliable wood that can be burnt for cooking or for warmth. The Mark 2 air vehicle will contain extruded vegetable spars or vacuum-packed components. We envisage manufacturing vegetable materials that can achieve similar tensile strengths as wood. And once on the ground, the vegetable airframe can be broken up and added to the food aid as additional nutrition. Pouncer is a first response vehicle and is capable of both air and ground launch, and we are in the process of developing extraction methods from cargo aircraft.
We will supply food that is regional, ethnically and religiously correct, and packed as meals into colour-coded containers in the fuselage and wing spaces. We're now ready to bring these technologies together and take Pouncer to the next phase in real-world situations.